In this video, I'm going to show you what I've come up with in order to super clean these Shop-Vac filters. It's something very simple, using some ordinary hardware parts available at Home Depot or your local hardware store, and a few 3D printed parts. So stick around. Some of the design is based off of the original Shop-Vac pieces. This is the mounting plate and mounting nut. Now, one thing I should mention is this is just a prototype. So if you guys have ideas of how you can simplify this even further, then make sure you put it in the comments below. Give me some ideas for improvement. It'll be on Thingiverse as well. So all of these 3D printed parts will be available on Thingiverse so that anybody can download them and print them themselves. So the concept here is that we'll have a bucket like this. Probably a little bit deeper bucket would be ideal. A couple brushes mounted on the inside and a lid, and this spindle needs to be turned down so that your drill chuck can hold on to it, and that's what I'm going to show you how to do right now. So I was struggling a little bit with the carbide tooling with this threaded rod because it was just kind of gummy. So I switched over to a high-speed steel tool and I made sure that it was honed and plenty sharp. So I was able to get a much better finish from the high-speed steel tool. I still came back with a little bit of sandpaper to polish that surface up. Okay guys, after a little bit of fiddling around and modifying the design just a little bit, this is what I've come up with. It was designed originally for the large filter, but it does fit the small filter as well, and I'll show you that detail there. Okay, just to walk you through some of the parts that you're going to need. half inch by 13 threaded rod. This is 12 inches long. You need a nut for the end, and this is drilled through and pinned in place, peened over and then filed. You need 1, 2, 3, 4 more nuts, half inch 13, and a few washers if you're using a filter that has a flexible top on it. I found that this helps to clamp that in place. As far as the 3D printed parts, you only need these three 3D printed parts. I've since modified the design to simplify a little bit and remove these pockets. Everything else is pretty much the same. One thing to note about 3D printed parts is that the size that you input isn't exactly the size that you get out. You need to make sure you have some tolerance. So for example, the nut size here, 0.736, that's inches, 18.71 millimeters. I would oversize the housing for that by half a millimeter overall, just to make sure I have clearance. Now that's my printer. Every printer is a little bit different, and it might have something to do with the material I'm printing. These are done with ABS, and they're done with the cubic infill, and that's at about 50% if I can remember correctly. So I thought I was smart when I designed this, and I had this small section here with the threads removed so that it could speed up the process of getting the nut from here to here. But that was kind of silly. You don't need it. So save yourself the time, just put your drill on. Easy. All right, so enough talk. Let's get to the testing. Let me show you how it works. So just leave that for a minute for the dust to settle, then we'll come back and see how it did. So what did you think? Do you think it did a pretty good job? I'm pretty happy with it. I think it does a good job of containing the dust. You still need to pour this out into something, but you can simply just put it into a plastic bag and pour it out. I think that would do just fine. So like I mentioned earlier, if you have any design tips that could be tweaked on this, by all means, let me know. Otherwise, you guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like, subscribe, and comment, and I look forward to seeing you on the next one. Take care.